Welcome back, Doron. I'm very happy to continue this conversation. So before we start, can you please remind us of the discussion that we had on the last episode?
Absolutely. First, thanks for having me again. So we spoke about the transformative impact that AI can have on Latin America, as well as Google thinking, how you can pursue AI in a way which is bold and responsible. And in order to do that, we spoke about the AI Sprinters report that Google published, which creates a framework that can help government, civil society, and private sector to push ahead and to capture the AI opportunity. And the framework that we discussed has four pillars, if you recall. One is infrastructure, digital infrastructure, investing in such. The second is equally important to invest in people, in people's upskilling. The third is how do we enable technological innovation, for example, making good use of data. And the fourth is enabling policies. How do you push for enabling policies together, working governments, private sector, those policies that can help AI thrive in Latin America?
So, Doron, the insights on economic potential of AI are truly enlightening and inspiring. But AI isn't just about numbers and growth. It's also about making tangible differences in people's lives. So in Latin America, as you know, we are very concerned about food security and climate change. So can you please share with us some examples of how Google is collaborating with Latin America countries to address those issues?
Ramiro, I couldn't agree more. AI is more than just numbers on a spreadsheet, right? It's about impacting people's lives in a meaningful way, and especially on the issues that you just mentioned. So let me give you a couple of examples. One is a project that we're doing in Colombia, where we're using AI tools to optimize crop yields and reduce waste. So you can see a very tangible way to improve agriculture using AI tools. Another project is Google flood alerts that we deployed across the region. A few months ago, I was in Brazil, and at that time, there were devastating floods at the southern state of Rio Grande do Sul. And we were fortunate enough to be able to deploy flood alerts. What we're doing is we're combining satellite imagery together with real-time data on the weather and using AI models to predict floods. And by doing that, we can predict floods 48 hours before the flood and at times even 7 days before the floods. And I was so proud to see that we were able to deploy those alerts using Google Maps and Google Search. And while working with the local authorities, we're able to alert people that floods are coming and actually save lives, right? So these are just a couple of examples of the value, the immense value that AI holds.
So those are great examples of how AI can improve people's lives or even save lives or help in food security. But while we embrace this AI potential, we must also be mindful of its risks. So can you tell me a little bit more of how Google is approaching AI development in a responsible way?
Ramiro, as you know, responsible AI is at the core of everything we do at Google. In fact, we were one of the first companies that came up with our own set of AI principles. And this was back in 2018. Those principles that govern how we develop AI, how we deploy AI. And the goal there was to maximize the benefits and minimize the risks. When you look at those principles, it's all about how you maximize the benefits for society. Now, this is a massive challenge, right? So it's really important that we come together here. It's not just about one company or one government. And we're also working with governments, and we're supporting some governments' initiatives. For example, the G7 Code of Conduct on Safe Use of AI is something that Google supports. At the end of the day, responsible AI is a collective effort. And at Google, we're committed to leading the way.
That is very reassuring to hear. And as we wrap up, Doron, I can't help it but think about the upcoming G20 summit in Rio. So how do you see AI shaping the global agenda in the years to come?
Look, G20 is always exciting. It's an excellent platform for international cooperation. And, certainly AI will be front and center this year. By the way, we're already seeing that the Business 20, it's the business community group that is putting together recommendations for the governments at G20, they're already looking at an AI framework, a framework that will address issues like safety, like governance, but also the great opportunity that AI holds. And interestingly, it doesn't stop with, it's not confined to just the tech sector, as you might expect. In the lead up to G20, there are other groups that are looking at different areas like anti-corruption and agriculture and women's rights and culture. And all those groups are also looking at AI tools that will enable breakthroughs, that will enable us to think about those things in a different way. So there's a lot of opportunity there. So bottom line, when I look at G20, I think it's a great platform for governments to share best practices. And I also hope that in the coming G20, we'll also think of new ways where governments and private sector can work together to make sure that AI is deployed in a safe and responsible way, but also in a way that can be bold everywhere and for everyone.
And speaking of G20, although you're far away now, we'll be seeing you soon in Rio. And thinking about that a little bit better, we could have waited and record this interview then, having Copacabana in the background.
That's a sure thing, right?
Indeed. But before I let you go, a few quick questions. So tell me one word to define AI.
Transformative.
And if you could have any superpower related to AI, what would that be?
Well, that's fun. I guess to understand and to speak any language, I think this will come in handy in my line of work. And also my girlfriend, Yael, is a linguist, so I think she will appreciate that.
And a message for business and society leaders that are hesitant to adopt AI today?
I would say, don't wait. Experiment now. The future belongs to those who adapt and innovate. And those who hesitate, just stay behind.
I really appreciate that, Doron. And thank you so much for joining us today and for sharing your valuable insights. It's been really a pleasure.
Thanks a lot, Ramiro. It was a pleasure. And hope that next time we can do it face to face.
See you soon.
See you soon.